Greetings. This is a Solar Watch for the 7th of March, 2012. Active region 11429 has unleashed a powerful X5.4 solar flare earlier today, and it does have an associated coronal mass ejection headed Earth's way. We're now looking at a split screen from the stereo behind Core 2, and we see a powerful coronal mass ejection has been released immediately following the X5.4 solar flare. Now this is a powerful coronal mass ejection, and we can see on this image a significant mass is definitely headed Earth's way, so we should see significant impact on the Earth's magnetic field as we feel the full brunt of this coronal mass ejection sometime on March 9. We're now looking at WSA Enlil solar wind prediction animation. Now they're showing a slightly earlier time of arrival of this coronal mass ejection on the Earth's magnetic field, and they're expecting sometime in the middle of March 8. Now this is a significant event, as solar winds are expected to rise to close to 800 kilometers a second on the arrival of this coronal mass ejection. We're now looking at the latest solar wind telemetry from ACE, and we see a significant change in solar wind speed over the last 8 hours upon the arrival of the coronal mass ejection that was supposed to miss the Earth according to the space agencies, but was forecasted to hit according to my channel and also my website, and it did so earlier today, with a strong move in solar wind speeds moving from 360 to 470 kilometers a second. Now this is a significant shock on the Earth's magnetic field, and I'm expecting a strong geomagnetic storm to result in the coming hours. We're now looking at the interplanetary magnetic field, or more specifically the BZ or BZ component, which saw a strong southerly deviation that reached minus 20 nanoteslas, which is a significant swing, and this is indicative of the coronal mass ejection having a negative polarity, which is a strong indication of a very powerful geomagnetic storm about to be in progress. We're now looking at the March 5th X flare and resulting coronal mass ejection with the use of Cactus. Now this is a significant coronal mass ejection en route to the Earth. Now we've already had one significant impact on the Earth's magnetic field. This is from the March 4 event. Now this wouldn't be too far away from hitting the Earth's magnetic field, as this was released 18 hours later. So I'm expecting over the next 6 to 12 hours, another impact on the Earth's magnetic field coming from this coronal mass ejection. We're now having a close-up look at this active region that's producing all of the activity over the last 48 hours using the SDO magnetogram. Now we have a close look at this region. It does appear to be 5 separate groups, all contained within one, and each of these regions or spots has its own magnetic field associated. Now as they move and grow, the interaction between magnetic fields produce these strong flares, and we can see some strong activity and movement over the last 48 hours, and that's why we've seen the strong flare activities. We're now looking at the stereo behind moving imagery and focusing on two powerful coronal hole formations that have developed over the last 72 hours. Now these are significant coronal holes, and these will be rotating the Earth-facing side of the disk in around 3 days' time, so we definitely need to monitor these coronal holes, as I feel there is a potential of an 8-plus magnitude earthquake in one of these holes, and this will be possibly in around 7 to 11 days' time, so this will be definitely worth monitoring and keeping track of, as there is a significant risk with one of these coronal hole formations. And that's my Solar Watch for the 7th of March, 2012. For more information, please visit my website at solarwatcher.net. where I'll be providing more content and information for anyone who's interested. Thanks for watching.